Hi and welcome back to a little bit of Calm and Crazy. My name is Jennifer and today I have three Dollar Tree wreaths to share with you. I am so excited about these wreaths. I just love spring and Easter time and decorating my home, and I definitely will be sharing everything that I create with you, and I hope you have enjoyed what I've created so far. If you are new to my channel, hello and welcome. I am so glad that you are here. I would love for you to take a moment and introduce yourself in the comments. If you still have not hit that subscribe button, make sure you do so you don't miss any of my DIYs. And if you enjoy this video, please give it a big thumbs up. If you don't know it, I am over on Instagram. I'm active over there every day. It's a little bit of Calm and Crazy over there, just like it is here. And let's go ahead and get right on into the wreaths. For these projects, I will be using burlap and twine for all three of the wreaths. Ha, got it right that time. Now, I do have some burlap from burlapfabric.com that I have left over that they sent me back in the fall. This is what the Dollar Tree ribbon looks like. You have a regular burlap as well as a wired one. This will work just as well, but I wanted you to see that you could use different shapes, different sizes, different edge finishes. It doesn't really matter, and I wanted you to be able to see how each one of these come together. So this is a huge roll that I got from burlap fabric. I have to cut it down because it's too big for me to work with, and I take my burlap and I use some hot glue in order to secure that to the wreath form that I'm, and this is a 14 inch wreath form from the Dollar Tree. After that, I just start wrapping. You will notice with this burlap as well as the others, it doesn't matter what width of burlap I am using. As I wrap, I overlap my burlap about half of the previous wrapping that I just did, if that makes any sense. And that is just to keep it more harmonious in the way that it looks. It keeps it from being see-through and all of that. I will say that this is the widest that I would use. As you can see, I do have to kind of manipulate it around the curves a little bit in order to keep it from puckering really bad. And so again, this is a 6 inch that I got from burlap fabric. Anything from 6 inch all the way down to 1 inch will work perfectly. Now, once I get to the very end, then I use some more hot glue in order to secure that. And then this wreath base is completed and I'm ready to embellish it. For the second wreath, I am using the wired ribbon that I grabbed from Hobby Lobby. I had some left over. Now, that is one of the best tips I can always tell you. Use what you have. Don't run out and get something new. And that's kind of what I'm showing you here, is I'm using what I already have. It would cost me more money if I wanted to go and stock up on just Dollar Tree burlap. So again, I take this all the way around. Now, if you get to a point where you run out of ribbon, or maybe it has a weird gathering like this one did, go ahead and finish it off with using some hot glue. Add some more hot glue to your next part, and then just keep going. You don't even notice that because it's all on the back. Wrap it all the way around till you get to the end, and again, more hot glue to finish it off. And then this wreath is all the way ready to be embellished as well. For this last wreath, I'm showing you how to use it with a raw edge burlap. Again, this came from burlapfabric.com. I always start off by hot gluing it and then wrapping it around. Now, with a raw edge, you will have some fraying as you go, and I just kind of ignore it at the beginning and I just keep wrapping it, and I don't worry about it. Now, this is definitely a personal preference on something like this. Some people don't like it. They don't like that the rustic feel that this provides. I actually still do really love it. I just think that it adds a different element of a texture. So again, just wrap it all the way around, and then when you get to the end, cut it off and use some hot glue to secure that down. And then I go through and I cut off and trim any of those frayed pieces that are kind of sticking out, and I just give it a little bit more of a polished look. And then this one as well is all ready for embellishment, so let's get to it. So going back to that first wreath that I did, I'll be using that as well as this cute little Happy Easter Bunny sign that I grabbed from the Dollar Tree. Some pipe cleaners as well as some twine. Now, this huge roll of twine again comes from burlapfabric.com. You can grab some from the Dollar Tree. I love having a huge roll though. So to start off, I'm getting my bunny all ready, and I'm just gonna be separating everything and kind of breaking my bunny apart, just using my scissors to do that. I even go in to remove the bow, and I probably should have heated up the adhesive maybe a little bit first, but that's okay. I know I got a little bit of damage, but I will be covering that up. So now I take some twine and I just wrap it around the carrot. Oh, I would say about 8-9 times. And then I just tie it off into a knot. I do that to both of the carrots. And then I move on to making my bow for my bunny. I'm using the same burlap that I used to wrap the wreath in, and I'm just
measuring it out by rolling it to see what size I need. After that, I use some hot glue in order to secure one end to the other and create like a little tube. After that, I go cut a smaller piece out of the burlap, and that will be for the center. So I fold my bow kind of like in a little bit of an accordion. I use a little hot glue to help keep that together, and then I go in and I add my smaller piece around the center, again using some more hot glue in order to secure that down. So fold it one way, then the other, and then anything that I have extra hanging off, I just use my scissors to cut that right off. Now to close my tube, I just use a tiny bit of hot glue and pinch my sides together. I do that on both sides. And now I can attach my bow to my bunny, again using some hot glue. And I just wanted the bow to hang on the one little ear at a diagonal. Definitely making myself a little girl bunny here. So to attach my bunny to my wreath, I'm using the pipe cleaners and some hot glue. So first I use the hot glue to put the pipe cleaner down, then I go in with more hot glue to make sure those pipe cleaners are not going anywhere. After that, I just take my pipe cleaners around my wreath form and I just twist them a few times and make sure that they are nice and secure. And then I just take whatever extra pipe cleaner I have and tuck it under. Now by doing it this way, you can use this wreath for other holidays or other things that you want to. You are not attached to the bunny and the carrots. Now for the carrots, I'm using twine because the pipe cleaner would show. So I do the exact same thing though. I use the hot glue in order to secure the twine to the carrots. After that, I just take it around. Now you can knot it or tie a bow. I went ahead and decided to tie a bow, but either way will work. I do that with both carrots, and then my first wreath is done. And I love how this turned out. For the second wreath, I'm going in with a wired burlap that I got from Hobby Lobby, as well as these beautiful stemmed pale pink eggs that I got from the 99 cent only store. If I know that not everyone has a 99 cent store, so you can use something like these bright yellow flowers that I got from the Dollar Tree, or anything that you find in store that you like as well that just has long floral stems. So I'm using the twine in order to attach my floral stems to the wreath, and all I do is start off by just wrapping around once and tying a knot so I have a good way to secure that before I continue wrapping. I just take my stems and just kind of curve them around the wreath, and then I just take my twine and I just wrap it around. Now I'm choosing to wrap it around the end of the stem where there are not, where the eggs are not, and that way the twine is not going to be interfering with the eggs themselves. And so I'm overlapping, and now I'm adding the second stem. I have a total of three of these eggs, floral stems, and I'm doing the exact same thing. I'm just taking my stems, curving them around, and then wrapping the twine. I do the same thing with the third one, again overlapping, and I just continue making sure that my stem is curved and everything is all together. After I do that and I finish wrapping around that third one, I tie it off, and then I go in with twine in very specific places to make sure that things are attached the way that I want them to. As you can see, the eggs are on nice and secure, but they're kind of just flying out to the side, and so I will just slowly pull some in, take some twine around specific parts of the stem, and then I just tie it on to the back, and I just continue this all the way around until I am 100% satisfied with the way that it looks. I just adore this wreath, and I'm so excited to hang it up for Easter. Moving on to wreath number three, I'm so excited. I grabbed this butterfly sign from the Dollar Tree, as well as this little chick welcome sign. I've already used the bunny that came on the bottom, and this time I will be using the butterfly and the flower. I'm also using these wood letters that I grabbed from the Dollar Tree, as well as a few different chalk paints in the Waverly brand. I have plaster, crystal, and celery. I'm also using this wax in antique. So to begin with, I cut out the center of the large butterfly, and I'm using a sandpaper to get off the little sticky part from the sticker, and I'm going in with plaster and painting this. I'm not being too thorough. I'm okay if some of the wood of the butterfly pokes out. For all of these, I'm actually just going to be using the back. I find that a lot easier than trying to sand off any glitter or cover up anything. I'm just going in for a little bit more of a natural look. So after I finish painting this, I set it aside to let it dry, and then I go in and I'm choosing out my letters. And originally I was gonna spell spring, but my package of letters does not have the letter N, which turned out to be a happy accident, I decided to go ahead and spell the word welcome. And since I just recently did a project with these letters, I had some left over, so I did have an extra E, and it turned out perfectly. So I'm using the color plaster and painting all the letters and the word welcome. Now I'm taking the color crystal and that small butterfly that came from that multi-piece hanging sign, and I'm painting that all over. Now this is the only one that I actually gave two coats because I really did want to make sure that you could see a little bit more of that blue color. And then after I finished painting this and setting it aside, I went in on with the flower from that same sign, and I'm using the color celery in order to paint this. Once everything dried, I went in with a wax in antique and I just carefully brushed it around the edges. I'm going in for a little bit of a distressing here. And once I had it brushed around the edges, I went in with a paper towel and I did a little bit of wiping and rubbing it in. And then I took a sandpaper and I really gave it a good sand just around the edges. I love how using a light grit sandpaper just really brings everything together. So I did the same thing with the smaller butterfly as well as the flower. So I went in with the antique, then the paper towel, and then I sanded. And after that, I went in with the wax and antique on the letters, and then I only used the paper towel. I did not sand the letters. Now it's time for me to embellish with some twine. So I place some hot glue in the middle of my flower and I'm just wrapping it around in this little swirl pattern, a little bit of hot glue, and then I just continue wrapping. Now, when I was originally doing this, I was doing it really flat and I didn't like it. So I decided that I wanted it to be a little bit more, I don't know, whimsical, messy, whatever you want to call it. So I was just kind of looping the twine around and holding it with my fingers. And then I would just kind of go in and put some hot glue underneath different sections and just press it down and get the twine to stick to it. And then I even went in with my fingers and I wrapped it around a few times and then put that down again with some more hot glue to help it stay nice and secure. And I just continued to do this until I had the look that I wanted, making my loops a little bit smaller as I worked towards the center and getting it exactly where I wanted that. And I just think the end result of this is so cute. I also used twine on the middle of both of my butterflies, and on the smaller one, I just added a little bit of a bow. And once that was all done, now it's time to add everything to the wreath. So before I start hot gluing, I do want a way to hang this. So I just knot a piece of twine together. I wrap it around the wreath and just loop it through itself so I have a way to hang it. And then of course, I'm going in with some hot glue and adding all of my letters down to the wreath. And I also use the hot glue on the flower as well as on the smaller butterfly. With a larger butterfly, I wanted it to be a little bit more secure than what the hot glue could do. So I went in using some pipe cleaners and I attached two pipe cleaners first. Again, hot glue down to get the pipe cleaners to stick and then extra hot glue to make sure it sticks. And then I just wrapped those around, twisted each one of those a couple of times, and there you have it, a super cute spring welcome wreath to hang on your door. I know that this is one of my longer videos, and if you stuck it out through all three wreaths, give me that little baby chick emoji down in the comments below so that I know. I really do hope that you love all three of these, but as always, I want to know which one is your favorite. Don't forget, if you haven't hit that subscribe button, please make sure you do before you go. Give this video a big thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!